In Storyboard Pro, we can import a 3D object into our projects and animate them to help sell the concepts that we are pitching in our panels. And we do so by using the transform tool over here in our toolbar. In this case, we have a Jeep that's driving through our scene, driving through this gate. And if we were to take a look, our camera pans down from the sign, and in this panel, the Jeep enters the frame and moves away from us through the gate. And in the next scene, we have a bit of a match action that we have to keep track of, but let's get to that in a second. So we have our 3D object, which again is a Jeep. I've already taken the liberty of using control and clicking the wheels and then right-clicking and going down to separate sub-objects so that I can add a little bit of independent animation to the wheels. And in doing so, it creates a group and tucks the wheels and the Jeep body inside of the group. The third layer of our group is a layer that I created called characters. It's just the back of our characters. There they are. Just to plant them in the scene. And now let's add some animation to this 3D object. So we can do that in one of two ways. We can either click on the little animate button up there within our layers, or we can go down to the timeline and click from in there. So let's pick on our Jeep, and I will go to the first frame of my panel. I can right click and make sure our navigation toolbar is showing. That's these two guys right here. The first button goes to the first frame of a particular panel. The button next what will go to the last frame of a selected panel. So let's go to the first frame. Let's click our Jeep and we'll turn our animate button on. And in doing so, you'll see a little keyframe has already appeared. Let's position our Jeep. I know I want it constrained in Z, so I'll use the top view and have it right around here. Maybe they'll enter the frame very close to camera. We can just see their backs, the backs of their heads. Let's again go up to our navigation toolbar and go to the very last frame. You'll see the time head is skipping back and forth. As I click these buttons, let's go to the last frame. And because the animate button is on, I can just move my Jeep and you'll see that the Storyboard Pro is drawing in a path for us. Just telling me that some animation is being applied to the layer. And there we have it. Just like so. So let's take a look at the wheels here. Let's add a little bit of animation to the wheels because they look a little stagnant. So we can go to our first frame again using our navigation toolbar. And let's click on the layer for our wheels. You'll notice there's no animation on those. So let's use this down here in our timeline. I just click that and the little plus to create a keyframe. Let's go back up to our navigation again, go to the last frame. And now let's just add a little bit of rotation on these wheels. I'm constraining in X. And you'll see the keyframe has popped in there. It's telling us that some animation has happened. And let's just play that back. See how that looks. Maybe a little slow. Let me see. It's not too bad. Let's try it one more time. Let's just finesse it just a bit. Maybe a little slow. Let's try that. Oh, that looks better. There you go. That works pretty good. And in the next scene, the hookup looks pretty good. So we can add a little bit of ease to our animation as well. So one thing, even though this is not what's projected in this storyboard, let's just pretend that once our Jeep gets to this point, it comes to a stop. It hits the brakes. So we do that by selecting a keyframe. We go up to the properties, and you'll notice we have the ease in and ease out box fields. These fields right here are by default have zero in them. They have no ease, but let's add a little bit of ease. And these are frame numbers. So I can give something like 8 and 0, 8. And this will add ease on the in and out of this particular animation. So you'll notice at the top of it, we're kind of slow, 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 and then it goes faster, and then slow, slow, slow once again. And maybe just to help illustrate this a little better, I'll set this to 0 on our ease in, and at ease out, I'll make that pretty heavy. I'll put that to like 1, let's say. And you'll notice that the position of our Jeep is automatically being updated to incorporate the ease. And if I was to play this back, it comes to a pretty heavy stop right there. So we can also add ease and tweak our path a little bit by going into the function editor. We select our layer and we click this little button right here, open the function editor, which will show us all of the individual values and color-coded. They are all color-coded. So that we can tweak each individual one. We can open these up a little bit so we can see their full names. And as an aside, if you go down to operations down here in the bottom left-hand corner, you'll see a little camera icon down there. So if we were to click this and toggle it on and off, this shows us the camera functions of a particular scene. And if we just turn it back off, it'll go back to whatever layer we are currently selected on. And again, this will allow us to just individually find a value and slight, ever so slightly tweak it. So again, they're color-coded. So here's the path Z, the blue. And if I just drag that ever so slightly, you'll see that it is updating our path. And right now it's clipping the background, which is okay, just to help show you how it's moving it ever so slightly. And let's just undo that. There we go. So another thing we can also do, let me click on the wheels. Because right now our Jeep is going into a pretty heavy ease, but our wheels are still moving at the same speed. We can add a little bit of ease to our wheels. So again, let's just click on our wheels. And right now we see the path of our wheels, but we don't want to see the path. We can uncheck our path. We want to see the rotation of our wheels. And we can add a little bit of ease to these. By selecting the velo band. And one way of doing it is just by adding a canned, one of our preset ease functions by selecting the first keyframe, going up to it's one of our presets. And I'll just pick the last one because it's a pretty heavy. And now the wheels will rotate fast, 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 and then the wheels will start to slow down as they get to this point. So let's see how that looks when I play that back. Yes, and our wheels come to a stop. Let's select our wheels again. Pull up our... And maybe playing with this handle just ever so slightly lessens the ease. There we go. So that looks a little better. So we can really fine-tune and finesse our path and our ease using the function editor. If we have animation that takes place over two or more consecutive panels, we can have Storyboard Pro do that for us. Let's look at an example. Let's move into the next scene. In this one, our Jeep is now tracking with the camera as we move through the field. Jeep moves down this road closer to that structure back there. An easy way of faking a camera move here would be to select our background. Let me just zoom out a little bit. We can use our transform tool to resize it a bit. Let's go back to our first frame. We can put down a keyframe. And we can go to the last frame of our panel and let's zoom it, scale it down like so. Pull our camera mask back up. Let's zoom back in again. And I'm just looking at the in and out points right now. And that works okay. Maybe we'll take the background and pull it down just a little bit. How about that? That may not work so well. Works a bit better. Okay, so we have a little bit of a fake camera move here just to show us moving through this space, but I think you already can kind of see what the problem is. Once we move to the next panel in our scene, as our characters are acting within the Jeep, our background sort of snaps back into its original position. So that's sort of a problem. We have some layer animation that we want to take place over the course of several panels within a scene as our characters act and point. So how do we do that? So we can tell Storyboard Pro to spread this motion over the course of these panels within this scene. So we do that by selecting our layer, our background layer, and we go to layer option in our menu and choose spread layer motion. And now it gives us a bit of a warning right off the bat when we open it. You can only spread layer motion into panels within the same scene. In other words, we can't spread this motion outside of this scene, either before it or after it. It must remain within this scene. And also, you're spreading the layer motion between layers of the same name. And we have two options here. Either we can choose to spread it to all of the panels within the same scene, or within the next, and we can click on next and give it a value. But in my case, I want this to happen through all of the panels within the same scene. I'll choose that. I'll hit OK. And now Storyboard Pro has done. If I was to hit playback, you'll see that our camera is, or I shouldn't say our camera, but our layer movement is happening throughout every one of these panels within the same scene.